A lot of stuff has happened with Live Survive over the last couple weeks, and it's really crazy because several months ago, I thought Live Survive was going on a shelf and that was going to be it. That it was just going to die and Steam VR was going to be the only way forward, or somebody else would come up with a completely new system to be able to use Lighthouse tracking with, well, without the rest of the whole system. And all that changed a couple weeks ago. In my last video, I showed how this little orange pie right here was able to drive the entire Vive headset, being attached to the headset. But right now, for convenience sake, we just have it sitting on the desk right there. In the last week, literally week, there's been an explosion in development in posers and other systems. So really, there's been two paths. So this first poser here is Justin's poser, and it's the EPNP seated SBA, EPNP being the effective perspective endpoint camera pose problem. It's normally used in reverse. Normally it's when you have a camera that's looking at a bunch of points and you want to figure out where the pose is of that object. Now it's very similar in that, but it is the opposite problem. And one of the other problems with this is it is both CPU intensive and it doesn't necessarily synchronize the two sweeps, but it's very useful for things like determining where objects are in 3D space in general, especially for things like maybe robotics projects and stuff like that, especially because it doesn't need the IMU. It doesn't really need any of that stuff because it's able to get the position, and then using small bundle adjustment with that 2D image, it's able to continuously refine that so that every single frame you have a really good estimate as to where the object is. Now, this is the way you'd solve a problem like from the top down. And if that's not really your cup of tea, there's a different poser that I've been working on. It has a lot of hints that have been given to me over all of this time from the developers at Valve, and I'm not really sure why I didn't take it before. Instead of trying to actually solve the problem of figuring out where you are...
By contrast, my poser doesn't really try to figure out where the object is in 3D space every time. Instead, it just uses where the object probably is, and in a particular sweep, well, is it too much to the right? Is it too much to the left? Maybe it's too close, maybe it's too far, and it updates based on that. Now, I was afraid to do this because things like rotation and whatnot would totally just rock it, and it would be very sensitive to any of these things changing. But there's something really cool. The Vive also has an IMU, and if you do make use of that, then you can actually stabilize a lot of these things out, and you can get very smooth motion out of this. Just really smooth, very, very low CPU usage. For me, the hardest part of riding this poser was the leap of faith it took to believe that the state wasn't going to get fouled as soon as the system started. But it didn't. By using the other systems, it was something that you could rely on. And that was really the hardest part for me. Now, whether my poser or Justin's poser is the right way forward, well, the jury's still out on that. And it's out on a lot of other things, too.
So, right now with Live Survive, with this refined model, things work pretty well. Not perfect, as you can see, sometimes this gun kind of like glitches off into infinity, and then right on back. And as I change which sensors are visible to which lighthouses, well, that's also getting hosed, because I'm still not sure how to get all of the calibrations in. And none of us really are. So if you have some ideas, and you think you might be able to help out with some more of the tracking, that'd be awesome. But, as I've just discovered, I thought once you get tracking, you're like 99% of the way to an immersive VR environment. And clearly that was wrong, because I'm pretty sure tracking is at least reasonable now, and this is not immersive. So already I found, well, four parameters, and I'm sure that there's many more that I'm not even sure what to set to. Things like the convergence for where... the position is for, I guess, where the eyes shoot off as they shoot off into infinity. And that's the thing that really matters. And that's not even the interpupillary distance, the diopter here. So I don't even know how to really set the diopter right. I'm just going with guesses here. Just things that I might just be able to try to get an estimate of. And things like field of view here. As I click the button on the remote, it changes which mode, and you can see in the background. And then there's not even just that, but like there's the distance in where your eye is relative to where it's tracking from. So, like, of course we're not all the way back here, but, like, is it here? Is it here? And trying to figure that out is something I'm just not really sure how to do. So, maybe you're the next person to contribute to libsurvive. Maybe you might be able to help this become a completely open source alternative, well, to something like SteamVR, but an alternative for lighthouse tracking. So, I hope you guys found this interesting, and I'm really hoping that I can do more things with this in the future. But it's going to take a little bit of time, it's going to take a little bit of effort, and it's going to take some more people and smarts. Hope you guys had fun with this. Thanks for watching.